Experts from the International Atomic Energy Agency are on their way to Ukraine's occupied Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant. IAEA head Rafael Grossi says the team will visit the plant later this week. Russia and Ukraine accuse each other of artillery strikes near the site. The attacks are fueling fears of a catastrophic radiation leak. Officials say radiation levels are still normal, but people living in the area are preparing for the worst.
People are queuing up in towns near the Zaporizhzhia power plant for this green tablet. It's iodine and could help protect them against a radioactive leak.
We were told that an adult should take one tablet. I have a child. They should take half a tablet.
They've been worried about a nuclear disaster since earlier this year, soon after Russia invaded Ukraine. We bought it the first time in winter, when the plant was shelled the first time. Emergency workers are training for the worst, moving victims who have been exposed to a radioactive cloud, cleaning them, and testing levels of radiation on each other. The Zaporizhzhia power plant is Europe's largest nuclear facility. Ukrainian workers have continued to run it throughout the war, but it's occupied by Russian forces, which Ukraine says compromises safety.
There's lots of heavy equipment at the plant, infantry combat vehicles, trucks, and even tanks. And worst of all is that in the last 3 weeks, they put this equipment near the power units number one and number two. It means they are now like mines.
Russia and Ukraine blame each other for shelling around the facility as the power plant stands exposed.
Well, for more, we're joined by our correspondent, Jan-Philipp Schultz, who's in the Ukrainian capital, Kyiv. Good to see you, Jan-Philipp. So the UN's nuclear watchdog is en route to Zaporizhzhia. What more can you tell us?
Yes, exactly. We are also hearing reports that the international inspectors are on their way right now, and they will probably arrive at the plant in the second half of the week. This is also consistent with announcements that the agency made some days ago. A lot of observers expected the trip to be imminent, especially after Putin gave up his opposition to the idea of the inspectors traveling through non-occupied territory in Ukraine. Here in Ukraine, the observers, the inspectors, the team of experts, they are definitely very welcome. People here are seriously concerned about a possible disaster. There have been reports regarding power outages over the weekend, new power outages, and also renewed fighting directly around the plant in the past 24 hours.
Jan-Philipp, there have been contradictory accounts from Ukraine and Russia about what's going on at the Zaporizhzhia plant. Is there any way to verify what's actually happening?
International reporters can't travel to the site at the moment, so there is no possibility to verify the information firsthand. However, we have talked to many employees that are still working at the plant, and we've also talked to the town's mayor where the plant is located. At the same time, we have Russia's history of systematic disinformation. Disinformation that can easily be falsified. So we can almost say for certain that Russia is using the plant as a military basis and that there have been false flag attacks by Russia on the plant. But having said this, there are also strong indications that Ukrainian troops have attacked the plant several times in the past weeks. And also the town's mayor didn't deny that there have been Ukrainian attacks around the plant.
Jan-Philipp, we've seen in the report, and you've mentioned as well, there's obviously concerns about radiation. What do we know, though, about the radiation levels at the plant?
The good news is that the recent measurements at the plant and very close to the plant have all been within the normal range, and the emergency systems seem to be in place. As we heard in the report, authorities are continuing to distribute iodine tablets, so there is no way to say everything is okay, but the radiation levels are in normal range at the moment, and everybody is looking forward for the team of international experts to arrive.
Thank you, Jan-Philipp Schultz in Kyiv.
Despite its major military efforts, Russia's territorial gains in eastern Ukraine have been limited. DW correspondent Jan-Philipp Schultz traveled to a frontline region where he met Ukrainians trying to get on with their lives despite the dangers they regularly face.
We're on the road in eastern Ukraine, 20 kilometers from the front line. In the last small town before the combat zone, signs of war are all around. At the local supermarket, soldiers do their weekly grocery shopping before heading back to the trenches. The situation is tense. In recent days, the Russians have stepped up their attacks. In this semi-abandoned frontline town, Diana and Alina want to serve the best cappuccino east of Kyiv.
Sometimes we hear the missiles flying over us, and we hear them exploding. It's scary. It sounds always so terrifying, but we try to get on with our work.
At first, their small conflict zone cafe was an insider tip. Now, soldiers often queue up outside for half an hour of peace and a slice of homemade cake.
When we get a break from the fighting, we come straight here for coffee.
Diana is proud that they haven't closed their cafe for a single day since the war started. Only once have they been forced to take evasive action, when Russian strikes came really close and people ran for shelter.
When we heard the shelling, we went to hide in a safe space. After a few minutes, we went back to work.
The women have set up their own small emergency aid center directly above the cafe. Here, they collect food, medicine, and hygiene products for families fleeing the surrounding villages. Some of it is donated. Some they buy with their own money.
We especially try to help the smaller children who arrive here from the occupied territories. We have everything, diapers, clothes, toys, all the things they need to feel better.
Diana and Alina have got used to working in a cafe on the front line. Still, they hope one day to use the emergency room again for its original purpose, having a good time.